All right, guys. Light questions in very dim light, though. Let's see how do we solve them. So we have this question from past paper where it says figure 1.1 and figure 1.2 show rays of light passing through same semicircular block of plastic. ये दोनों एक ही material यानी कि plastic से बने हैं. So इनकी characteristics, इनका refractive index भी same होना चाहिए, right? Now they are showing us the light, right? So यहाँ से light आ रही है और ये air है obviously और ये फिर वो medium है. Let's call it plastic with P or just write that and then back to air, right? So we know that air is the if I just mentioned that. So if air is the lighter medium and plastic is the denser medium, right? So we know that कि पहले वो एयर से डेंसर में जा रही है यानी कि प्लास्टिक में जा रही है. बट यहाँ पर बहुत दफ़ा स्टूडेंट्स पूछते हैं सर फॉर्मूला अप्लाई करना है, कुछ भी करना है, कैसे एनालाइज करेंगे कि कौन सा अप्लाई करना है, लाइटर टू डेंसर या डेंसर टू लाइटर. सो द आइडिया इज यहाँ पर देयर आर नो एंगल्स टू वर्क विद. हैव दे गिवन एनी एंगल? बाय द वे यहाँ पर तो रिफ्रैक्शन हो भी नहीं रही, लेकिन इवन अगर रिफ्रैक्शन हो भी रही होती फॉर इंस्टेंस, बट सिंस दे हैव नॉट गिवन एनी एंगल्स हेयर सो यू आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू डू एनीथिंग हेयर, बट रादर यू आर रिक्वायर्ड टू डू समथिंग हेयर. फाइन, बाय द वे देर इज लाइट रे रिफ्रैक्टिंग हेयर. बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट समझते हैं इसमें कुछ भी नहीं ऊपर हो रहा, सो देर इज नथिंग हेयर. नो, देर इज दिस लाइट गोइंग दैट वे, राइट? सो समथिंग अनफेमिलियर. सो लेट्स सी हाउ इट वर्क्स. Now there's more information to it, and that is Q is the center of straight side of the block. So Q center mein, right? ये बात भी हम कर चुके हैं, दोबारा मैं रिपीट कर देता हूँ कि जब भी लाइट रे एंटर होती है सेमी सर्कुलर या एनी कर्व पाथ में जहाँ पर इट इज़ हेडेड टूवर्ड्स द सेंटर, राइट? सो इट कम्स इन सच एन एंगल where it is 90 degree to the surface, so it doesn't bend. This is just an extra information, nothing to do with this question at the moment, but thought case is good to clarify one of the concepts. Now let's go to the question. So the first part of the question says state the value of the critical angle in the plastic. Plastic mein critical angle kya hai? Now we know that critical angle is that angle at which refraction is 90 or the light bends along the surface. If we look at these two diagrams, something is happening here. So this angle of refraction, if we take it from normal, if this is normal, so this angle of refraction is 90 degree, right? And it's bending along the surface as well. So whatever this angle is, this is our angle. A lot of students will get confused and take 44. No, it's always measured with respect to normal, right? So 46 degree is our key angle. So the critical angle here is 46 degree. Right, now the next part of the question is, what is meant by critical angle? So let's write very specific words here. So it is that specific value of angle of incidence at which the angle of refraction is 90 degree or light bends along the surface. And obviously while going from denser to lighter medium. It never happens from lighter to denser. It always happens from denser to lighter medium. Alright, so this is a very important point here. It should be part of your answer. Now let's move to the next part, which is calculate the refractive index of the plastic. State the formula you use. Now here, you can use both of the figures. Figure 1.1, you can use figure 1.2 as well. अगर ये वाली फिगर आप यूज़ कर रहे हैं तो आप स्पेसिफिक फार्मूला यूज़ कर सकते हैं ये वाली. सो आई एक्चुअली यूज़ वन फार्मूला सो टू अवॉइड कन्फ्यूजन, राइट? एंड दैट इज़ यूजिंग फिगर 1.1, विच इज़ प्रिटी ईजी. and sometimes students like easy stuff. So from figure 1.1, the formula I'm going to use is this one, n is equals to 1 upon sine c. This is the formula to find refractive index as well, when you know the critical angle. And since in this question we know the critical angle, that is 46, so we'll simply apply that. So the formula works like n is equals to 1 upon sine 46, and if I put in these values in the calculator, the answer I will get is 1.39. Now the idea is that since it's made up of same material, no matter you take this or you take this, whatever calculations you do, the refractive index should be same, because yahan par they both are made from the same material. Alright, so refractive index is actually is all about the material itself. Alright, so now the next part of the question says, sum of light reflects back into the plastic at Q. Yeah, we know that partially it reflects back even when light is refracting. On figure 4.1, draw the reflected ray at Q. So figure 4.1 pe hume reflected ray banani hai. So for this, I'm going to take proper tools, which we're going to use, and that is D for sure. So D pe mujhe reflected ray banani hai at Q. Now if I look carefully, I have to be very careful while making this, so I don't get any parallax error. Okay, there you go. So once I figure out that I put it right, I don't know if you can see my head as well in the video as well or not. Anyways, so what I'm going to do is I have to draw 46 now. So, oops, I put it wrong way around, so I have to do it again. Lucky me, that happens. It's alright. That's part of the process, right? So to avoid parallax, I'm going to jump in again. Just do that. Small adjustments. And I will reach there. And there you go. So here you go. Now I have to draw 46. So starting from 90. Remember, from normal it should be 46. Not starting from here. No. So from here, 46. So you go 10. You go 20. You go 30. 40. 45. And here you go. This small sharp point is 46. Now all I need to do is take ruler and join this with point Q, right? And I'm gonna draw this with partial lines, because this is partially reflection happening at this point, and this angle is also 46 degrees. Remember, for reflection we learned that the angle of incidence and angle of reflection should be equal. That's law of reflection, right? I hope that makes sense to you. So finally this part is done as well. Good.